So, dear students, in last class or last session, we completed 2G architecture. In this session, we will complete 3G. What is the advantage of 3G over 2G? 3G has got separate voice channel and data channel. So, in the diagram, you can see here 3G voice and data network architecture. So, what is there in the 3G voice and data architecture? So, 3G, the core network. See, in the diagram, you can see here. So this is the core network. This core network connects to the mobile user, resides in data radio service network, to public internet. So along with the separate cellular voice network, that means in 3G, data network, core network has been modified or incorporated in parallel along with the existing cellular voice network. So that is the main advantage of 3G. Now we will discuss the various components of 3G core network one by one. So the core network here, you can see here the core network. So core network here contains SGSN, and second component is GGSN. Now this SGSN is called as servicing GPRS support nodes. And gateway GPRS support node. GGSN is known as gateway GPRS support node. Now GPRS is nothing but generalized packet radio service, which we are using in 2G. But in 3G, we are calling this one as SGSN. What is the main function of the SGSN? The main function of the SGN is to route the datagram from radio access network, to GGSN. That is nothing but the gateway. So this is the last component in the 3G, where the datagram sent by the mobile node will encounter and before which enters into public, very large big public internet network. Other than this, our GSN, other than that, our SGSN will contact MAC of that area and try to get mobile location information and mobile mobility, accounting, authorization, all these things. So this is the concept, or this is the way the SGSN and GGSN works. This is called as a core network. Now we will see radio network access area. This is called as radio network access area. In the radio network access area, is the first hope is user's wireless access. That is the first hope. Second one is here, radio network controller, RNC. This RNC, earlier it was similar to BSC, that will service many BTS in 2G system. So other than that, our radio network controller will connect MAC and SGSN. Radio network connector also called as here by UMTS, 3G UMTS. It is called as 3G UMTS. So, and radio access network controller makes use of technology. The name of the technology is here, which is called as DS and WCDMA. This is the technology used by our radio network controller. What is this technology? DS. That means it is a CDMA technology, and it is fully known as direct sequence wideband CDMA, which provides multiple frequencies. In this way, our 3G architectures works.